shot of him then as well. Decided today to get up early and a bit of a walk along the Jurassic Coast. So this is a pretty special part of it. I'm going to start off at Houn's Tout, which is kind of a high elevated part of the coast overlooking Chapman's Pool, and you've got amazing views east and west. And we'll take a walk west along the coast towards Kimmeridge and Clavel Tower. There's a bit of cloud today, but it might be broken cloud, so we might get a bit of a sunrise. Anyway, we'll see what the day brings. I've got the camera, hoping to get some. Well, there's some eye shine. You see that? Hoping to get some bird shots on the coast, and you never know what else we'll see. With all these eyes looking at us. Anyway, see you in a bit. Thank you. Don't you just love the mornings? And there's no one else around. No traffic. No hustle and bustle. Just the sound of the wind. Sound of the sea. Sound of nature. Or no sound at all. So we're just heading towards Houn's Tout now. So try and get your bearings. That's towards the coastline now. And then that way's west towards Weymouth and Portland. And then beyond that, Chesil Beach, on towards Devon. And then that way, looking east along the Jurassic Coast. Dilston, Swanage and Poole and Bournemouth. Devil's coach horse beetle. Isn't that beautiful? Just see the first glimpses of it getting light now. Seems to be quite a bit of cloud, unfortunately. And sit down, wait for sunrise. I'm going to sit down here overlooking Chapman's Pool. I think you might like the views later when it gets light. Can't quite see them now. It's a pretty spectacular place. Just get a sense of what's going on now in the sky. Just a crack of colour all along. The sun should be coming up over there. So now you can see where we are. So down here, this is Chapman's Pool. It's a lovely little secluded cove. Thank you. bit right at the top where it slows down a little bit. The flashing light. That's the Needles Lighthouse on the Isle of Wight. And then over in this direction, we've got Portland, the Isle of Portland off Weymouth. And then right on the tip there, you can just see the light flashing. That's the famous Portland Bill Lighthouse. So I'm just gonna sit here for a bit and have a brew. Lighter, and then we'll go for a walk along the coast towards Kimmeridge, which is this way west towards Kimmeridge Clavel Tower, and you can have a look at that that coastal path. Part of it. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but being outside, whether it's, you know, just generic countryside, whether it's in a forest or woodland, land, or by the coast, there's something really therapeutic about it. I know a lot of people struggle with life nowadays, mental health issues, or whether it's the stresses of life, pace of life. I would advocate just getting out, getting some alone time, getting out or with friends, just being outside, and especially the early part of the day when there are fewer people around. It's so uplifting. I think whether you've got a camera or not, it doesn't matter. Just go for a walk.
I see colors when I can't quite work out why. Am I as glad I'm on the ocean or way up in the sky? Am I alone or with friends? I hear thunder.
So we're going over there, so I'm going to follow the coast path and over towards Kimmeridge. I don't know if you can hear those on the video. Just pheasant calls. There's just an abundance of them around here. You see those sheep? The field. They're just advancing like a line of soldiers. Can you see that? That would be so cool on a time lapse. Just come from there. Beautiful place. Looking forward to going back up there on that hill later. So I think these are getting the winter coat now. Getting set for the harsh conditions that they'll find. being here exposed on this south coast. Well, they're still advancing in a line. Slowly but surely. You hear the pheasants? See, just being out. Just being outside. In the countryside. You just don't know what you're going to see. I mean, I've been here before and seen kestrels, buzzards, peregrines, foxes. Gives you much more of an opportunity to catch these things, you know, notice them and maybe get a shot of them if you've got a camera. But even if you don't get a photograph, just seeing them, just such a privilege with our ingress into the green belt. Diminishing amounts of kind of wild areas for the country's wildlife. It's just a privilege every time we see something. You should never ever take anything for granted like that. Because one day you don't know. We just might not have them anymore. These trees are amazing. I think this would be a great spot for some astro time lapse. Could you imagine being here at night alone? That'd be so cool. Again, that's where we were sat having a brew earlier. And Chapman's Pool just in there. Kind of wondering why they called it, what they call it, the Jurassic Coast. It's a kind of perfect example of one of the reasons why. Just look at that. Look at that rock formation, the strata. It's a fossil hunter's paradise. This way you get these different rock formations and the age changes towards near Exeter in Devon, about 90 26 miles along the coast. It's what the UNESCO Jurassic Coast encompasses. But there are many places you can see it similar to that. Another famous, or a couple of famous places where it's really evident is at Lulworth Cove. You've got amazing geology there. If you look out to the entrance to the cove, some of the strata there is really wonderful to see. And obviously at Durdle Door. We're here is the entrance to Kimmeridge Bay. Just there, the end. A low tide, there's some ledges that are revealed by the low tide. And you can get out there and do some nice long exposures. But there is somebody out there now. Sculpture. So this morning we were sitting up there on top of those cliffs from this way towards Kimmeridge, and over here should just be able to see Clock Tower. Not that one. That's Clavel Tower. I think it's owned by English Heritage, and you can actually rent it out as a hotel, B&B, so you can stay there. Although I think there's a big long waiting list, as you'd expect. It's not a bad position, is it? presumably not bad views to wake up to. That person is still out there. Whether it's a photographer or... Swire Head, a high point. I'm going to try and show you this person out there before it disappear. Fisherman, photographer. This is the old site for Clavel Tower, and it had to be moved back away from the cliff because of erosion. It's pretty cool. This is Kimmeridge Bay. Guy's back out there. I think he must be a fisherman. Right at the end. I think he's got a tripod. And if you go further that way, we've got Warbarrow Bay, Mute Bay, leading on to Lulworth Cove, Dirtle Door, Bat's Head, and then beyond, and then that's the Isle of Portland. This is another fantastic place for fossil hunters. Hope you enjoyed this little wander along the Jurassic Coast. I think you'll probably agree it's quite a nice place to be. Look at that up there now. So I'm going to make my way back to van now, and I guess I'll see you all on the next one. Alright, stay safe, take care, and I'll see you next time. If you like the video, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'd be very grateful if you did. Nice to have a kind of community. So anyway, I'll see you guys. Thank you.